Hello everybody, it's Tisha here again, and we are back.
Something is not right.
Thank you. That's better.
Smells like a trap.
Cast about this land, my friend.
Go! Get the murdering dog!
Christ! Bullshit!
Go, my eyes.
What used to say here?
Take the mask down.
Set the mast up!
Are you feeling all right?
We need to row our way out.
We can continue.
Shall we raise the sail, Eivor?
Danes did not do this. It's the... We know it's the Danes. It's always the damn Danes. Make them pay Vergil for the dead that now litter the fields.
Show sense, please. What would the Danes gain from the slaughter of poor farmers?
Look! There's a filthy Dane now. Why don't we ask?
I did not touch your herd.
You fools are making this worse.
These Saxons fight like mad dogs to protect their own. I cannot blame them.
Thank you for staying your hand, stranger. What is your name?
Eivor, of the Raven Clan in Mercia.
Wolfhilda, Abbess of Barking, and inquirer into mysteries.
Are we here for the same reason, I wonder?
Aye, to look upon devil's work. But why would a Dane from upriver care what happens to Saxon farmers?
If there's a rabid wolf or bear on the prowl, I would see it dead. Blame often falls on my folk for such carnage.
Well and good, Eivor of the Raven Clan. Take a look at the maulings, and tell me what manner of rabid beast did these things.
I could start with the dead cows.
You there. What befell this poor beast?
Danes befell it.
How can you be sure?
It was Hrothgar's warband. They're holed up in that old church, working their misery upon us.
Warriors do not often go about slaying milk cows. Besides, I have heard talk of a beast on the loose.
Bite marks, but not from any beast I know. And the corpse is covered in strange mold, though the wounds are fresh.
Real.
You saw the devil himself taking his tithe to hell.
You are brave ones for getting so close to this awful sight.
I saw it, Warrior. I did. The night it happened, I saw it all.
What did you see? A wolf? A bear? Maybe a rabid hound?
It was a Jotun, as straight as a tree. And it laughed while it ripped and teared. It yelled out its name, Grendel.
Huh. Blood still wet as dew. Where does it lead?
By the gods. What manner of beast flung that poor creature up here to its doom?
What sort of beast leaves glistening mold over freshly killed prey?
Yet that woman blamed the Hrothgar, his band of Danes, were the killer's men.
Whoever it was, they were mighty enough to get a mauled beast corpse onto a rooftop. That little girl said the creature was a giant, calling itself Grendel. This may be the work of a band of drunken Danes. Or worse. I should discuss these clues with Wolfhilda.
Wolfhilda, I have learned all I can from the villagers and those dead beasts.
And what is your take on the mystery? Still believe a wolf or bear did these things?
This is not the work of a woodland creature. The bite marks, the mold, most art.
So you admit this is the devil's work? Or one of your wooden dragons come to life?
A few maulings do not make for a devil or a dragon. It must be a man, or a pack of them. The girl mentioned a name, Grendel.
No. No mortal hand could rend flesh in such a way. Surely you see that.
I have seen the worst the hands of men can do. Deeds bloodier than this.
And these men stalk the night, slaying cattle as they go.
True. This thing I cannot explain.
3 times these attacks have happened. Each time, bite marks, broken bones, and streaks of mold. Something wicked walks in East Anglia. Some other animals were attacked in the woods northeast of here.
Let us go.
This way. We may find more clues. Should be up there in the trees ahead. Can you smell it? It reeks of death and evil.
I know that scent well. Carrion and death. Loki's reek. Did the wolves get a bite of you?
No. I'm unhurt. Thank you, Dane. I misjudged you.
No need. But tell me what happened.
These beasts came scavenging for fresh meat.
I meant, why are you out here with the dead cattle again?
I'm searching for my best milch cow. She's missing.
And you found her?
No, but I found a Danish axe. It belongs to Hrothgar, leader of the warband.
You know for a fact this axe is his?
Yes. He brandishes it about the village, demanding ale.
I will speak to this Hrothgar and his warband. That woman is certain a nearby band of warriors caused these maulings. We have no other clues.
I know the men she means. They're staying at the church near Brisleague Farm. Come, meet them. Their leader, Hrothgar, is a great man, for a heathen. He is no cattle killer.
You have curious opinions, Wilhilda, and an uncommonly open mind.
I should say the same of you. Most heathens would point to witchcraft or monsters, but you seek an earthly cause.
I have seen many strange things, but the answers are usually close at hand, if only hidden.
True. Yet in this case, the church has tasked me to explain the unexplainable. That, at times, introduces unholy ideas.
And your church accepts your unholy ideas?
They tolerate it. Lucifer is a deceiver, and God himself works in mysterious ways. So I, too, must remain open to all possibilities, mundane and otherworldly.
Which is why you tolerate a heathen like me.
Perhaps. Or perhaps all of us, heathen and Christian, stand within the fold of a greater mystery. Something's off, Eivor. Hrothgar's men are rowdy sorts. Hair is far too still.
Stand back, priestess. This is war work. Have a care, Wilhilda. The killer may yet linger here.
I do not see him among the dead.
I shall find him. See, more fresh mold. Same as in the fields on the cows.
The villagers say it is the devil's mark. What do you say, Eivor?
I say find the mold, we find our killer. The same marks as before. Bite marks and mauling. These are not weapon wounds.
What manner of demon can fell so many well-armed warriors? Eivor, look up. More blood.
Someone crawled into the loft, or dragged the body up there.
Hrothgar sometimes slept in the loft. Have you looked up there?
Leader of this warband.
I am. A Finnmark raider and proud of it. For the little time I have left.
I bear ill news. Your warriors have fallen. Who or what did this awful thing?
The monster did this thing. It killed us while laughing. Laughing! Broke my axe and gouged me. I crawled up here to die.
What was it? Did you see?
A foul Jotun. A nightgoer from the world's rim. It spoke. Named itself Grendel. Said it would return.
Good. We shall wait for it to come back, you and I.
Not I. My wounds are too great, and my spirit takes ship. Send them to Helheim. For me.
Ride with the winged women, friend. I will handle this Grendel, whatever manner of monster it may be.
Wait. Warrior. There were... two...
Best hide. Do not scare the demon off when it returns.
Wait up here for it to show itself again.
Get your rest, warrior. I will stop.
Wulfilda, be still. Something stirs.
Mother.
Play. Grendel only want to play. You make Grendel hurt. Mama, I want to go home.
By all that is holy and bright, what manner of monster is that thing?
Not a monster, but a man. Strange to behold, but this Grendel is... was... man.
But where did it come from?
All men have mothers. This one called out for his in the end.
And all of us, even the most hideous, have souls. Oh Lord, forgive this man his sins, and grant unto him your grace and everlasting love.
Mold everywhere. Stay here, Wulfilda. I'll follow this trail.
Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May all these souls rest in...
Tracked this mold here, but from where?
trail leads southwest. More mold. I'm on the right path. Go, Zulin. Have a look soon. Into this pit. Reek. Oh. Woman speaks of her child, Grendel. Cruel fate the gods have woven.
Fitting. Yet, what use is a key when... Look.
curse is lifted. About the Danes.
To protect my boy. He never meant to hurt anyone. But the others, they could not see. He kept growing in body, but not in mind. He was my boy. Sweet little Grendel.
Wolf Hilda must know the truth of this. Thank you.
Abbas.
Eivor, you live yet. Pray, tell all.
I slew a monster that was but a man. Then I tracked his mother and killed her too.
His mother?
She struck at me in the dark and I defended myself. But it was no hero's deed.
Those poor souls. I shall pray for them tonight at Barking Abbey.
Leaving already?
I must. The bishop is eager for a full accounting of the Beast of East Anglia.
Leave my name out of your tale. It is nothing to be remembered for.
Understood. Perhaps it would work better as a song. I dabbled in verse as a youth. It may be time to lift the pen again. But what story shall I write? The full truth of this thing may be hard to fathom.
Give them a comforting one, about heroes and monsters. For the truth, the bone-cold truth of everything is often hard to take. It cuts like a cruel north wind on the neck.
God saves us all, Eivor. I take my leave now, but will write to you once my poem is complete. Farewell.
Thank you, and farewell to you too, Wulfilda. Make it a good tale.
Thank you.
Expecting.
Saw a rich man's home burning. Yet he was hopeful, and death stood outside his door. It is always better to live, even in misery. Soon, guide me. This place is not very welcoming. To be careful, I have to go through this. another chamber. May this one be as fruitful.
Who disturbs my centuries-long slumber? I well deserve this rest.
When my husband, chief of the Iceni, died...
They defiled my daughters, then me.
I burned their camps, Colchester, London, Albanas, desecrate...
But there were too many.
Defeat...
First.